I am a lecturer in psychiatry. Many of my students struggle due to the challenges they face, be it language problems, financial difficulties, poor self-esteem, challenges linked to the poor socioeconomic background. I find students sometimes very frustrated as they will utter the words, "I am studying so hard, but I just forget the work. And I really want to be a nurse." This takes me back to where I am coming from, Pontyville, an area aspiring to a better life, but where children were struggling to get a good education. It takes me back to my own struggles to be able to study psychology. I remember at that time, there were no bursaries for this field of studies for me. I remember how I went back to work in a factory after completing my matric certificate, utterly frustrated, peeling onions. I remember how at another factory, the boss, a German guy, came out of the factory saying to the people waiting for employment, "In you go, off you go." If you didn't get the job, it was off you go. It was off you go for me. And I said to him, "I need the job because I need the money." "In you go," he said. I remember later applying for a nursing program to at least get some education, even it wasn't my preferred option. I remember that students rioted for equal rights and better education in 1976, playing innocently in the street as children, while tear gas was thrown at us. I remember during those years, innocent people died. I remember students singing the song, "Freedom, oh freedom, freedom is our perfect harmony. And before I'll be a slave, I'll be buried in my grave, and be home to the Lord and be free." When I look at my students, still struggling, my heart goes out to them. Take for example, Andili, a very shy black student, very, very weak academically. Although I explained the work to him at various occasions, he was still struggling. He appeared sad, and I saw the fear on his face that he was not going to make it. I was putting myself in his shoes. I knew he was a victim of his poor socioeconomic background, just like me. But I also saw the drive in him to not give in. To not give up. I was determined to help him. I tried different types of teaching methods. I invited Anjali to extra classes. I encouraged him to take part in his discussions. Role plays to help him grow more confident. To have his voice heard. Anjali eventually passed, but not with excellent marks. Later I saw Andili as a Cosmo registered nurse in a hospital I was visiting, smiling as he came up to me, saying to me, "If it was not for you, miss," I said to him, "Andili, thanks a lot. Remember you did it. You must be proud of yourself." While I stood there with him, a song was playing back in my head. "We shall overcome, we shall overcome, we shall overcome someday, for deep in my heart I do believe that we shall overcome someday."